Well, as we have already established, today is Earth Day, Earth Sunday. It's kind of an Earth Week, I think, all over the planet. So we're going to take some time to reflect on what it means to care for this wide, wonderful planet of ours. However, instead of just stating the obvious, which is that we need to wake up and start treating this old Earth better before it's too late. And I mean, like, wake up right now and really change our foolish ways. But instead of, you know, dwelling on that, I want to dwell a little bit on why it's important for us to appreciate what God has given us in creation. To appreciate all that is around us and how it makes our lives incredibly rich. And I'm using Psalm 23 as a jumping off point for that. I know that normally when we hear and experience the 23rd Psalm, we think of it as a poem of comfort. It reminds us that God cares for us and that God is always with us, shepherding us through all of life's ups and downs, from the green pastures and still waters to the valley of the shadow of death. Today, I want to zero in on the fact that when the psalmist wanted to capture the greatest moments of God's care, he talked about lying down in green pastures and walking beside still waters. God makes us lie down, surrounded by green grass. Stop for a moment and remember the last time you actually laid down in the middle of a field and looked up at the blue sky. I can feel the sun on my face. I can smell the earthy goodness of the grass and the soil. And I can hear the buzzing of insects surrounding me. God makes us lie down in green pastures. God encourages us to walk beside still waters. If I add up all of the time, and I think Pat Whitney may be the only one that beats me on this, if I add up all of the time that I have spent next to water, it's got to be over 2 years put together. Close enough to a body of water that I could just go outside and touch it. Being near water has always been a life-giving force to me. Being able to watch the water, hear the lapping of the waves, floating at night, looking up at the sky full of stars. Yes, I really do that. I sometimes make other people do that with me. Both of my kids have done that. Calvin Smith, who's normally sitting right here, and I would be embarrassing him right now, but he's off getting ready for a concert. Calvin Smith, I made him do that with me. Tamlin, however, has not done that with me. Because she thinks I'm crazy to get back into the cold lake after dark. I think she may be right, actually. There's something very life-affirming to be close enough to nature, close enough to God's creation, that you feel totally immersed in it. Why is that? I want you to think of how we use the healing, calming power of nature, including animals, to bring healing and peace and renewed hope to people. Sometimes when I visit folks in the hospital, I'm lucky enough to be there when one of the therapy dogs comes around. Regardless of how that person is feeling, these dogs come into the room and it's like life is suddenly becoming sunny. They bring joy wherever they go. That's their job, and they are really good at it. It's especially true in the pediatrics ward. Children who have been thinking about needles and medicine and having to be brave suddenly forget all of that when an animal comes into their room. They become children once again. A very deep part of their soul is touched by unconditional love and unconditional licks of a canine companion. Why is that? And it's not just in hospitals. You probably know that they use horses as therapy for people who are profoundly autistic. When nothing else gets through, you put them on a horse, and suddenly they are connecting with something outside of themselves. The touch of an animal sometimes unlocks a door that has been bolted shut for years. People are changed by the presence of animals. Why is that? Children who have been deeply scarred by emotional abuse may be extremely wary of other people, but an animal will open their hearts to trust and care again. An animal can do something that no human could ever do. Why is that? Young people who have hardened themselves and find themselves rebelling against the rules and estranged from their families will be sent out into the wilderness for a couple of weeks with guides to keep them safe. And over time, they begin to collect themselves into a new way of seeing life and relationships. Why is that? The Lord makes me to lie down in green pastures. God leads me beside the still waters. Hardened criminals, hardened prisoners who have pretty much burned all of their bridges and who have often reoffended and come back to prison because it's the only world in which they can function, are paired with a dog to train. And more often than not, it's like life beginning again for the first time. Their lives have a purpose because now there's something that they have to care for, and now there's something that loves them back unconditionally. The most hardened people start to slowly soften up and begin to look forward to tomorrow. Why is that? I've talked about this before, but for many of us, when we immerse ourselves in nature, it's like our real church. It's when we feel closest to God and our true identity. Why is that? I think the 23rd Psalm holds part of the answer to why that is. Because in that psalm, we are compared to sheep in need of a shepherd, a kind and loving shepherd who will care for us. Now, I don't think that being compared to sheep is necessarily the kindest comparison possible, but I think there's more to it than that. Because like sheep, we, you and I, are a part of creation. Now, I know that some of you are thinking, well, duh, of course we're a part of creation. But how often do we see ourselves as separate from nature and the animal world? We forget that we are animals too. We're a part of creation. We don't just go visit it now and then. We're a part of it. God created us to be connected with nature because we are a part of nature. God created us to be at home in the midst of the woods or in the mountains because we are a part of creation. Now, I have to admit, we do a pretty good job separating ourselves from the rest of creation and isolating ourselves from our natural surroundings. We build walls that separate. We cover ground with concrete. We protect ourselves from rain and sun by putting up roofs. We insulate ourselves to the point that we actually do need to go visit nature now and then, just to remind ourselves that it's still out there. All the while, God has graced us with this great gift, which is really our home, the place where we belong. That's why I think when we look out at the water or lay down in a field or pet a dog or ride a horse or watch a hawk soaring overhead, a part of us comes alive. God wants us to do just that. The 23rd Psalm uses the most basic connection with nature to represent God caring for us. Think about that. The 23rd Psalm uses the most basic connections with nature to represent God's caring for us. When we connect with nature, we're doing what we're created to do. Be a part of creation. Feel a unity, a belonging, feeling at home in this wide, wonderful world. Why do we feel such comfort through animals? Why does looking at water lower our blood pressure? Why does lying in a field connect us with the earth? Because we're a part of the natural order of creation. We are not strangers out there. We are family. Perhaps if we could get more people to understand that connection, it would be easier to get people to care for the rest of creation. This is our home. This is our only home, our place. We're connected to the oceans, the air, the ground, and the other animals. The Lord makes me to lie down in green pastures. God leads me beside the still waters. It's that connection, those beautiful places, all those comfort and therapy animals and their wild cousins. They bring us healing, hope, joy, love, and meaning. All of creation gives us so much. God gives us so much through that connection. And the rest of creation is sort of depending on us to return the favor. After all, we've sort of made a mess of things, haven't we? We need to think about the great gifts of God that surround us, the gift of being a part of it all. And then we need to do our best to restore this home for all of our sisters and brothers in the great family of creation. Amen?
In keeping